So here's the thing. We're not quiet on Preston New Road. Julie and I popped down to nip to the loo, and while we were down there, Pete Marcus' truck was coming down, and four or five of us were crossing the road, maybe somewhat slowly, admittedly, and for some reason, the Pete Marcus long, heavy vehicle panicked. He just panicked, and as he came past World of Water, he struck a really quick right down Moss Road. Moss Hill Lane? Are you really sure? I thought it was just one word. Moss Road, Hill Lane, whatever. Anyway, so just before Maple Farm, and there were two police vehicles with him, and so as we were leaving to come back up to PNR, we thought we'll just take that Moss Road and see how we got on, because there's a sharp bend and no way he could possibly do it. And oh, you could see that he didn't make the bend very well, lots of black marks. Yeah, and the roads aren't fit for that vehicle, and I wonder what the police are going to come and tell us. Oh dear, do I open my window and run the risk? Look, they're going to reverse back into us.
Don't your window up, do you?
Ah, fine.
We can't do anything. I'm just being normal. And I've got...
Oh, wait, there's a car. Oh, there's another yellow one. It's them! The other slope. No, I'm not going
to
say.
As far as I'm concerned, I'm taking you two to the top end so I can drop you off. Can we not go around this way? Oh, sorry, I've got my window on.
No.
Hi, can I not get...
No, you can't get through. There's going to be a block for quite some time as well. Hello, Tina. How are you?
Why is he stuck? Why did he use this road?
Pardon?
Why did he use this road? He's too heavy. He's too heavy and too long.
I can't possibly answer that.
He went into a panic and he turned right when he shouldn't have done.
If you want to get out of the vehicle, I'll have a lovely conversation with you.
Oh, why? I'm too tired.
Like.
I won't tell you where he's here.
Oh, okay.
You're willing to get out and leave your phone here and I'll plug you.
Will you? Will he arrest me or something awful?
I can arrest you, darling. You've done something all wrong.
You hold my phone. You hold my phone.
Yeah, when she has go forward. Well, I thought if I go forward a bit, then she can come out, and then I can reverse back in. I can't, because sweetheart, will you hold the phone?
Okay.
Is she railing with him? Oh no, she's not. She's smiling for it. I just really don't want her to get out of here. We go now.
Thank you. What a shitty day, all in all. Other than the fact that there's no work.
The sun's shining. All right, Tig.
Stop swearing, Tina. So rude.
I wouldn't speak to
you.
You have to get ours.
Right.
Did you get me? I bet you didn't tell you that as we walked off, though. I bet you on the bottom of his t-shirt.
Did you? Did you? Brilliant.
Didn't we?
I tell you what was really useful, though. Some of those pegs were on the bed. And just when there was sun burning, I needed to somehow tie scarves on. Yeah. Found all the pegs. It was brilliant. Where has she left her car?
Got it. Okay, so police have said that they're moving some heavy farm machinery. They're not all jobs that Marcus does are for the quadrilla. Whereas I'd say, I don't know.
He suggested that perhaps they were just picking up farm machinery. That was planned all along. But we watched him take that turn, and that was not a happy turn. That was a dramatic one.
That was a very quick turn.
Yes. And why would he have had police escort?
No, he had that coming down. And they've just come round this way. Now,
he had it coming down, but they came with him. But why did he have a police escort if he's just here to pick up farm machinery?
Because they knew what was going to happen. They're not stupid. They know everyone's on radio. I'm going.
Anyway, let's go and tell Darren. I'll delay. Anyway, so that was that little bit of drama that broke up the whole Oh, yeah. I'm going to run out of data in a minute, so I'm trying to put a seatbelt on. You know, I'm a law-abiding citizen. That's it. So, yeah, so this is the lane that they came down. So, I know it's nice that the police gave us a story that sounded really interesting. I don't necessarily know that I believe it, because, you know, the license to lie, really, because they're there to keep the peace. Yeah, so, but at least we didn't get threatened. They just got threatened, the other two. They got told if they don't move, then it's an obstruction. I wouldn't mind. He said to me, he said, thank you very much for getting out of the car. You know, I don't always appreciate being filmed. He said, you know, sometimes it can get a bit much. I looked at his chest where his camera's on me.
I know.
And I said, 6 years of activism, babe. 6 years of staring at your breasts. I said, and constantly being filmed. There are years of film footage.
You've got no right to say anything.
Yeah, anyway. So it's been a long night. So, LockOn's still on up the top. We came down for a loo break and a quick salad sandwich. And we'll be heading back up shortly. And then ended up on a chasing a Pete Marcus band. Couldn't help it. It was a distraction too good. Anyway, so, right. And I'll come back on later. In the meantime, do check out Kieran Dunn and Frank Roberts, both of whom I know are live streaming at the top, where the 13-person LockOn, when I left it, had the first two out. Arrestees sent to Blackpool Jail. And the next two were going to be sent to... Preston, so it's scattered.
Okay,
yeah, that might be easier. That make sure you tell Darren what all went on. Yeah. All see right, you later. That was a fun adventure, guys. Yeah. So, but I've got to go and get some data sorted and things first. So do tune into the others.